Hey guys, this is Tim from OpticsPlanet.com, and today I wanted to talk to you about thermal imaging products. What we have here today are various thermal imaging units from a weapon sight, a camera, a monocular, and a clip-on unit. And these are units that allow you to see the differences in heat. In the environment throughout the day, all the materials around us absorb and radiate heat at different temperatures, and these units allow you to see the differences in them. A lot of the questions we get are common myths on thermal imaging. Thermal imaging cannot see through solid objects, it cannot see through walls, it cannot see through clothing, and it will not see through glass. And despite what Hollywood shows you, you cannot hide from thermal imaging by covering yourself with mud, because thermal imaging sees differences in heat. We receive a lot of questions about the differences between night vision and thermal imaging. Night vision is the traditional green images that you see. One of the biggest advantages to thermal imaging over image intensifier night vision is that thermal imaging does not project anything and is passive night vision. Image intensifier night vision often uses IR illumination in order to see because it uses small amounts of visible light. When using image intensifier night vision with an IR illumination source, certain animals and anybody with a night vision device can see you. With thermal imaging, since nothing is projected, animals will not know that you are there. Many of the thermal units we sell have 1x magnification. We have additional units that have 3.5 magnification all the way up to 6x. Another difference in these units is the refresh rate. A refresh rate is the amount of times the unit updates the picture it's seeing to your display device. Common refresh rates are 9 Hz, 30 Hz, and 60 Hz. The lower the refresh rate, the less amount of times the unit updates to the display. A low refresh rate, like 9 Hz, is kind of like looking in slow motion, where 30 Hz or 60 Hz is kind of seeing in real time. If you're going to be hunting, you're going to want a rail-mounted unit, such as the ATN Thor or FLIR RS weapon scope. Both these units come with optional magnification and have reticles built into the unit. This particular unit has 1x magnification and would be great for hog or coyote hunting. Another option for hunting is to buy a clip-on unit, such as this ATN unit here. The advantage to this is that it clips directly on the Picatinny rail in front of your daytime optic, converting it to a thermal weapon sight. The advantage to the clip-on unit is that you don't have to change anything about your daytime setup, allowing you to later remove it without losing zero on your daytime optic. If you're looking for something for exploring or scouting, you'd be better served by going with a handheld FLIR unit. This would be better suited for you rather than a rifle scope with a reticle, and they are more compact for field replacement. Handheld thermal units are useful for building inspection. Allowing you to check your insulation for heat loss, this will lead to huge energy savings. If you need a hands-free unit, the ATN Onan would be a perfect option. This unit is in a PVS-14 body and allows you to use the same accessories as with the PVS-14 scope, meaning it is great for hands-free applications. As you can see, there are many different options for thermal imaging. I hope this video helps make your decision easier. If you have any other questions, please leave us a comment or send us an email. I'm Tim. You can find all these products at OpticsPlanet.com. Thank you for watching.